of her friends tried it too. So church lady, sing her that song. Sing her that song. Sing her that song. Sing her that song.
We're back. Can't stop us. Can't stop, won't stop. But this is the reason we're moving over next week to Twitch, okay? You know, we're just here to have a little fun, and hopefully the day goes by a little bit faster, a little bit quicker, because we were a part of it. So just trying to bring music to your life, and this is my girl. Not my girl, but Angie Stone. Tell me when you hear this record, it just doesn't make you feel good, right? Angie Stone. Another another retro remix by Mr. Hex Hector and Max Quayle. These guys were, I mean, listen, not because Hex is my brother and best friend, but these guys were unstoppable. Dynamic duo. They just understood each other, right? And both had these talents that they brought each other to the studio and just made magic each and every time. So, kudos to Hex and Mac. And this is a little edit that I did of Hex's remix. Some loops, some hi-hats, and of course the Backstabbers. Happy birthday, buddy. Remember this one? Classic Armand Van Helden. The guy would sample anything and make it a hit record. Maria Chetos, stop texting me, girl. Don't you have like some pasta and sauce to make on a Sunday? Is coming up, everyone. 2:30 for the legend and the diva and the amazing person who's brought us so much amazing music throughout the years. 2:30, Deborah Cox will join us live. So share it, tell your friends, get everyone on board. She's going to be participating in some chat, right, on Facebook, and you can ask her questions. So ask away. We'll be right back. out going out to Peter Bailey. Peter Bailey mix right here. The Soul Searcher. I think this was on Twisted. Twisted America. Peter Bailey, where are you, buddy? You still alive? We miss you. Peter, we miss you. Your friends miss you. Let's go. My favorite records from two people that I'm really close with and love and admire. Amazing, amazing DJs and another set of producers that have stood the test of time. Chus and Ceballos. Through with you. It's an oldie, but it's a goodie, man. At 2 o'clock, at 2 p.m., get your shot glasses ready. We're going to cheers. We're going to toast. We're going to celebrate life. You know, it's been a lot of weeks now, and we're almost out of it, but we gotta stay smart, stay safe, stay home. Don't listen to Atlanta. Stay safe, everyone. Protect your loved ones. That's the most important. You gotta think about your grandmothers, your mothers, your daughters, your sisters, right? And protect them. Shusha Ceballos. Everyone, thank you so much for tuning in. We appreciate it. I think this is what week, what, Lee? Six or seven? Six? Not seven, right? Week six. And if you asked me 6 weeks ago, would I ever do this, I'd tell you no. So it's amazing how things happen and life changes, right? Because this happened before a blink of an eye. And I want to really thank Mr. Hoscarelli. Now, if you are not in music business, you don't know Hosh, right? But if you're in the music business, everyone knows Hosh. And Hosh was this guy who was the A&R for Arista Records. And we all used to admire and want to work with Hosh, right? Because Arista Records, the cream of the crop, right? So when you get to work with Hosh, it was a really, really interesting thing because you would submit a mix down, and this guy would hear percussion at a half decibel increment. He would say, Jason, you got to go back to the studio. I need it a half dB up. I'm like, half dB? Your ears are like golden. But that's like an inside joke. Hosh, with all due respect, thank you so much for being my friend number one. And, you know, I met you in, I think, 1996 on the dance floor of Arena. And I was with Razor from Razor and Guido. Their career launched because of you, right? With Fable, Robert Miles. And, you know, later on, we became closer friends and we worked together with that Swingtown remix, Steve Miller Band. And I just want to thank you for being an awesome guy, being the best A&R guy in the business, and, you know, putting this whole thing with Deborah together, because if you did not make this happen, it wouldn't have happened. So thank you, Mr. Hoscarelli.
You're not for me.
Now this little gem right here is from DJ Scribble. He did this little Deborah. Now, now Hosh right now will be like, girl, what's this? Yeah. Oh, yeah. Mad love going out to Mr. Johnny Vicious. Another one, another guy who defined this whole time in our lives, right? Remix after remix. Going out to my friend, Mr. DJ Escape, Jeff Jonas. I'm proud of you, Jeff. You know why. I'm proud of you. Nice to see you on here, Jeff. Love you, DJ Escape. We won't talk about the perch. Love you, Jeff. This one, Veronica. This was on Jelly Bean Recordings, or another sub of Jelly Bean. But Shay, we wish you well on the move, Shay. I mean, the girls would go crazy, right? Right, Lee? The girls are like, reminds me of CPI. Big Room. Oh, man. I miss those days. We'll be back there soon, people. Don't break a hip. Rob Mirage, I love you, buddy. Jen. Jen. Hi, Jen. Rob, Lee does not care about you. Remember Neptune Beach Club, huh? On the deck, Neptune. Like a little improv yesterday with Deborah and Hoscarelli, just to test everything out, right? And we were talking about drama. And remember when records had this break and it was drama and it was just 11 minutes of goodness, right? Not like today. Records are like 4.5, 5.5 minutes. It's almost like a radio mix for the clubs. But back then, when we were growing up, it was all about this, right? Here we go, Johnny Vicious. Minutes. 6 minutes until our shot. So get your shots ready. At 2 p.m., we're going to have a little cheers and toast to celebrate life together. When you get an acapella of a record and you love it and you have some free time in your hands and just go in the studio. That's what happened with this record right here. One day I just found this acapella. I went down to the studio in my old home and came up with this little edit. It really turned out to be a big record for me and a big little edit for me, you know? Never commissioned, so I never got paid for it. But, you know, back then, you didn't do things for money, you did it for a passion, so. Going out to my amazing friend, another beautiful spirit that's entered my life, Mr. David Knapp. I'm the only straight guy who ever brought a gay man roses. And it's because David was filling in for Junior at Palladium. And we were super close at that time. So I knew what it meant to David. So my old partner and I actually brought him a dozen roses to the DJ booth. He was like, girl, you brought me roses? And you know, didn't matter back then if you were gay or straight. It was just about the music, the nightclub, the environment, and people loving everyone, you know? There was no boundaries. So, David, I love you, and I mean that. Thank you for being in my life.
I'm gonna light up till now. It's the light of day that shows.
All right, people, get your shot glasses ready. We're going to do this one for the legendary Miss Whitney Houston, right? She's dedicated so much of her life, or all of her life, to music and making all of us happy, right? So, Whitney, may your soul rest in peace, and may your music live on forever. Cheers. That's good stuff. Remix that we did together as Mindtrap, and then we had gone, you know, like everyone else, they just go your separate ways. There was a moment in time that I'm proud of, and we're proud of, right? But this was the last remix we did together, and when we got the call, by the way, the artist is Cher. I hear you, girl. And we got the call, and it was like, do you want to do a Cher remix? And we're like, what? Right? I mean, you know, Cher is legendary. She's a star, right? The costumes, the stage presence, she is an artist. So we did this remix for Cher, and it was one night she performed at Roxy, and it was at the end of Roxy. And it was just a moment that I'll never forget. So thank you for asking us to be a part of this project. Cher, A Song for the Lonely, Mindtrap unreleased remix. Oh, DP Cookie, my aunt. Hi, guys. To my family, I love you so much. Cheers to you as well. sorry, but this remix was pretty good. If I pat myself on the back, I am. Because we really did a great job with this record and took it to another level. And I'm proud of that. Not cocky about it, but I'm proud of it. I haven't played this record in at least 15 years.
Wherever you may go.
And Joe Magic, thank you for being a part of this.
You don't have to look no more. 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 Don't have to look, gonna see the light.
Remember everyone, 2:30, the legend, the diva, this Deborah Cox will be joining us in 20 minutes. We're super excited. My Trap remix. That was the last one. Now this was the first one, right? And it was always a song that Jerry wanted to do, and he knew this riff that he wanted. And I mean, if you know the original album, it is one of those albums that will always stand the test of time by the Steve Miller Band. Every song in this album is amazing. So this is the first Mind Trap remix, I think in 1996, 97, 98, I don't know. But Pasquarelli and Arista Records, also about 5 years or 7 years after, signed this record, so we actually got paid. Isn't that sick? Because we did a bootleg and we sold 22,000 bootlegs of this record. So don't come back to me, but it paid for our studio. And we developed as young producers and remixers. And then Hosh paid us again. So thank you, Hosh. What a riff right there, right? So thank you, Hosh. And Joe Magic, don't get excited. We weren't paid a lot, but we were paid something. So don't come knocking at my door, Joe Magic. How you doing, baby? Love you, Bobby. Trying to dodge Facebook police here. So I'm playing all my own records, which I never do. I never play my own stuff consecutively, record after record. Just, I was never me, but I'm doing this now to try and dodge the police, right? So don't think I'm like Mr. Ego here, because I'm not. Just trying to dodge the police. But rest in peace to this artist who I had the pleasure of working with, Miss Kim English. And if you're gonna ask me which one of my productions was I most proud of, it was probably this one, because the message in this record is pretty beautiful, you know? And I thought the arrangement, what I'm really proud of is the arrangement. Because it's like this intro that just keeps on going and going and going. But there was always another layer to the intro. And that's the magic of Joe Magic, right? This guy just had these fingers that would just work. So the creative process between the three of us just worked, you know? So thank you, Joe, Jerry, and to the Mind Trap crew. A great moment in time for sure. whenever I see you, girl, give me a thumbs up if you hear me okay and if you see me okay. Hi, Deborah. Now, you guys can't see Deborah, but I can, right? So, Deborah, if you hear me okay, give me a thumbs up. Oh, wait, I got two thumbs up. Girl, it's a good day. And you look good. She looks pretty. So, Deborah, a few more minutes and we'll come to you, okay, honey? Again, everyone, thank you for tuning in. We have the legendary Miss Deborah Cox coming in to our broadcast in a few minutes. And we're just going to talk the talk, you know what I mean? So we hope you're home, staying safe, your families are safe, of course, your loved ones, the people you love, friends, family, no matter who they are. And we'll get through this together. That's been the message for the last 6 weeks, so. Crazy to me to know that I made this record 22 years ago. I mean, this was our first big record in the remix business. And I'm not sure if this one went number one, but it was close up there. And we are super proud of it. Miss Kim English, may her soul rest in peace, and thank you for all the music. So one last check with you, Deborah. You hear me okay, correct? Okay, got you, girl. Ladies and gentlemen, I bring you Miss Deborah Cox. Hi, Deborah.
Hey, Jason. How are you? Happy Sunday to you.
Happy Sunday. I really appreciate you coming on. You know, it's a big deal. You're a big deal, girl.
Thank you. Thank you.
Especially thank you to Hosh for making this all happen. So
absolutely.
You know, Deborah, we went through a little rehearsal yesterday, and we talked about the whole thing that's happening with this coronavirus.
Yeah.
And where we are today. So what has happened to you throughout this whole process?
Well, I think it was a break that we all didn't realize we needed. You know, I think, I've been on the road a lot. We're always on the go. You know, if it's not live gigs, you know, touring, it's recording sessions, or it's, you know, shooting movies. I mean, I've been super, super, super busy. I'd say over the past, just grinding over the past, 10, 20 years, right? So I never really take a break. The only time I've taken a break was if I was with child. So this has been like a welcome time to just reorganize, recalibrate, reset, and get a lot of things done that I haven't had a chance to get done in a long, long time. Like cleaning out my closet.
Oh, I love that.
Yeah.
So listen, Deborah, unfortunately, I'm going to have to restart this, right? Because what's happening in my headphones is I'm hearing a consistent loop of over and over and over again. So whatever we're saying is happening, unfortunately, over and over, and I can't even focus on what's happening. So I apologize to you, but we'll get you back up in 2 seconds. I'm going to play another song.
Okay.
Restart this and then come back to you. Sounds good? Thank you, honey.
Sounds good.